that movie, Everything All Everywhere All at Once. There's a lot of us out there, a lot of versions that we could be. We ultimately are always one, though. So it's like, which one are you going to be for the rest of your life? And that's the question I think you always have to ask yourself. It's the question I ask myself every day. I wish I could predict the future. I wish I could know in 5 years if I'm actually going to be partnered or not so I can make different financial decisions. But I don't know. So I'm just kind of planning for both.
Yeah.
You know? That's fair. It's like, yeah, it kind of drives me crazy because I could do both. I could be single or I could be partnered. I don't care. It's like so indifferent. It doesn't matter. But like, I don't know which one Brittany's going to choose.
My chat is so tired of us talking about that movie. We've been talking about that movie so much.
I mean, I think it comes out like tomorrow.
We're back at the movie again. Coming out.
I think it comes out on DVD. I'm going to buy it. The moment it comes out on streaming, I'm making all my brothers watch it with me. Because they're going to love it. It's going to be a great conversation.
It's so good.
My youngest sister and my dad just watched it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I want to call them, but it's nighttime, so they're going to go to bed. But like, because I really want to know what they think about it.
Yeah.
He texted me, was like, yeah, I have to think about that movie. That's all he said.
So good. I haven't been able to talk to people in my Discord because there's a lot who haven't seen it and I don't want to spoil. But every time we have like another member in the Discord be like, guys, I saw it. We'll be like, okay. And then we'll like sequester to like a private smaller call to be like, let's talk about it. And then we just talk about it for like 5 to 6 hours. It's just, and everyone's perspectives are so different. It's like, I feel like every time I hear it, I like, oh, I just love that movie.
Yeah, for sure.
Good recommendation.
We have a Discord thread too. Some people who decided they didn't like it though, in the minority, they like didn't, it was interesting like talking to people about why they didn't like it or why they did. And so I'm curious, I'm doing a podcast on it soon, but I always do wonder like why certain movies make sense to certain brains while others don't.
Yeah, this movie doesn't make sense to some brain. That is insane. I'm so curious what they're experiencing. If they did not,
how did they not like it? Did they just think it was weird?
In my chat that did not like it.
A lot of people.
One person in. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, Melina, go.
One person in my chat walked out of the movie theaters.
What?
Didn't like it. Yeah.
Why? Because it was just like so weird. Because it does take a while to get to its point. Like the whole time it's building, you're like, what the fuck's going on?
But the beginning is so good too. It's just like, the first like 10 minutes of the movie is just perfect.
Were they offended?
Like the dildos or something?
Anything offensive in it? My conservative parents would never watch this movie. So offensive to like all the people who I grew up with. They would never watch it.
Oh my, that's so what I've heard too.
There's like
some people.
Sex toys and sex references and butt stuff. What do you mean?
Oh.
But yeah, some people.
I think my dad really liked it. I think he got emotional when he saw that.
See, that's cool. That would be cool.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna have that. My mom is very much like Evelyn, like in the sense that I grew up in a culture where like you don't talk about it, don't bring it up, use everything in code. So like, actually, Evelyn's more liberal than my mother. She actually let the girlfriend come around. My mom would never. My parents won't even come to a non-secular or a non-religious.
And then also in another universe, she would have been with a woman as well.
So that was my favorite. Jamie Lee Curtis's character was the best. She was my favorite. So good.
The sausage fingers.
So funny. Yeah. So great. No, this
story
was
so good.
Yeah, some people didn't feel as deep as it felt, but I think if you come from like a certain background, a certain part of the world, your brain works a certain way, the movie will make more sense to you. But if you like, I just feel like it's an experience. Like you're supposed to experience the movie. You're not supposed to think about
the movie. It's not a movie. It's an experience.
It's an experience.
Yeah, I definitely.
It's beyond what a movie is supposed to be. In my opinion, it's beyond what it could do.
Yeah, I kind of light judge people who don't like. If people like really don't like it, I'm like, you don't get it, and that's a shame.
Yeah, you don't
like,
get it.
I don't think they're a worse person, but I'm like. Okay, that's fair. You're just not ready for it.
For sure. I'll say it this way. I told my Discord, if you don't like this movie where you can't get married, stop hitting on me. And they were just like, and it's because it's the same way I feel about anime. Like, you have to like anime because you have to like this movie. You have to like movies that force you to like feel your feelings. Like, I want you to feel your fucking feelings. Like, when Steven told me, because the only reason I saw it was because Steven was like, Brittany, it made me cry. You have to see this movie. And I was like, okay. And that's why I went and saw it. Because I was like, Steven cried?
Yes. He was like, I was sitting next to him, and he was like this at the end. For like 5 minutes, like this.
Same.
It was just like.
My friends and I were asking.
And I was like, I looked at him, I was like, there's no way this movie made him that. Like,
same.
I've never seen him like this because of a movie before. This never happened. He was like, holy shit. Like, that was insane. That was just crazy. And then we talked about the movie for 6 hours. And we were like, we're never going to find a movie this good. It's just like, okay, this is the best movie we'll ever see. There's no way.
Yeah. Does that bring you guys closer in your relationship? Like, you guys know how you say you want different things, but like, if you both felt connected to this movie, do you not want similar things in a weird way? I know it sounds really stupid because it's a movie, but like, I feel like if you see this movie and you feel motivated by it, I wonder if we're all motivated by different parts of it. Because I felt like this movie is telling us, like, you have one stupid life. Pick it, be joyful, find a way to make it work. In a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Like, this is it, baby.
It's like, I think it just told me more about that he... I feel like he might have not liked this movie years ago. I don't know if he agrees with that. Because I think the past few years, maybe like 3 years, I feel like when I met him, he was not a very super, like, emotional person. He's not very emotional now either, but he was worse. And I bet that 5 years before I met him, he was even worse. And that's why I'm thinking maybe he didn't like it. But now that he's been a little bit more comfortable opening up to things emotionally, and he cares about that, I think that's probably why he liked it, I think. Because he got moved by, like, all the relationships and everything. Yeah. He felt something about that. Yeah, I do
think that. Makes sense. So. That makes sense, yeah. Actually. Mm-hmm.
Man,
makes me happy. I'm happy that he got emotional to it. Yeah. It makes me like, okay, he's not like a cold, just like, there is emotions in there.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, man, I'm so nervous to talk about it because I have so many questions, but I don't want to, like, spoil it for people.
It's been out for, been out for a while now.
Okay, my theory is that the grandfather is the villain the entire time. It was never Joy. Yep.
Because he was kind of like, because he let her go, kind of.
Because he was like so, he was so like dogmatic. He was so dogmatic that he like made a shitty life for his daughter and was like forcing that a little bit onto his granddaughter. And he was willing to kill his family to like save something when like the only way to save it was like to lean into to your family, to like loving them. And he was willing to like kill his own family. Like I would argue like he's the big villain of the whole.
That's so funny. I didn't think there was any villains. I didn't think there was any bad guys.
I think he's like everyone else, kind of, right?
Yeah,
but he has a reason for being the way he is. Yeah, I think that's when in the movie I think I got the most emotional when she asked him, "Why did you let me go?" Mm. That was like, that was probably that's when I was like breaking. I was like, okay, this is crazy.
Yeah,
this is just crazy. That was probably the worst one. Yeah. Or worse in a good way.
That's okay. I was trying to explain that, like, this is like I call it a borderline movie. I do. I'm like, this is a borderline movie. Because, like, so much of, like, rejection and acceptance is, like, ultimatums. And I had those ultimatums growing up. If you don't like the rules, you can leave. And, like, it's like, if you're gay, you can leave. If you're this, you can leave. And so it's like, well, I don't want to leave. And they're like, but if you do this, you have to leave. And it's like, why are you letting me leave? Like, why are you pushing me away from you? And so there was, like, a lot of that in this film where he, like, the father was like, and I've had these conversations with my own parents, like, you know, this is a weak man. This is a weak person. Why are you doing this? And it's like, because I have to do this. Like, I don't understand why you can't just be there for me. Now, eventually, my parents, you know, came around in many, many ways, and they're still working on it. Like I said, they're, like, more than happy to have us over for Christmas, which is, like, a really big deal. Or, like, we can openly say, like, oh, like, I want to date a woman, but then my mom does this, like, oh, Betsy, please. Like, you know, it's not, like, accepted, though, right? And I can accept my parents for who they are. Like, I humanize people, like, the dad, the grandpa especially. Like, I can humanize him to such a T and see, like, why he came to where he was, because I look at my parents and the conservative bubble they're in, and I'm like, I understand, because, like, even, guys, I was even at a point in my conservative bubble, this is so embarrassing, where even I was like, gay people don't need to be married, women shouldn't be president, just everybody's chill. And now I'm like, the idea of thinking that way is so funny to me. I can't even remember what it felt like to feel that way. But I knew it was real at one point. Mm-hmm. It really was real for me.
It was kind of like, just be happy with whatever you have right now.
Be happy with whatever.
I think that's like, Just like, you don't have to think about that. Just like, you're fine. You can survive anyways. You're good.
Yes,
I think it's more about that, yeah.
Exactly the mindset where it was like, it's fine, I guess. And so I think that's so, like, this
makes it easier. It's, like, more simple.
Yes. Yeah. It's, like, better the hell I know than a hell that I'm unsure of, like, or a future I'm unsure of. And so when I went for the future I wasn't sure of, I got hurt a lot. I'm not even going to lie. Like, a lot of people always say that to me, like, don't you think it's telling that you've had only pretty bad relationships in your 20s? I was like, don't you think it's telling that I actually tried? Like, mm-hmm. does no one want to give me credit for fucking breaking my heart 1,000 fucking times to figure it out? No, that's fine. But it is what I had to do. Because if I didn't do that, I would have stayed in my conservative bubble. I would have been married with 12 kids and I would have been divorced and unhappy mm-hmm. and not know why yeah. I'm unhappy.
Yeah.
At least now I know, and now I have no kids, I got no connections, and I'm about to buy a house all by myself, girl. Hello, praise Jesus.
It's so funny, Brittany. I don't know if I told you, but after Nick and I watched this, I was like, this movie's kind of about Brittany's level of system.
Thank you so much.
And Nick was like, yeah, yes. I know.
Yes, thank you.
It is. It is about that. And I was like, man, the internet is not ready for this take, but it's out there now. So, it's fine. Everyone already thinks I'm your number one biggest simp. So I'll just wear it with pride.
Women simps are my favorite, but like it was. I got out of that movie. I literally got out of that movie and I was like, I fucking told you the levels were real, you fucking doubters. I was like, fuck yeah. And like, literally my friends and I were together and they, like, we were crying so hard. And then the people came in to like clean. And I was like, I think we have to go now. And like, we walked outside and it felt like I was floating on air. And I was watching all the people in the mall. And I'm like, here they are. Everyone following their little scripts and in their little bubbles and with their families. And they're happy and they're joyous. And they're, but they don't, like, some of them know why they're there and some of them don't. Like, people will look at me like I'm the freak of all nature. But I'm looking at them like, aren't we all though? Like, we're all the same. There's no hierarchy. That's why ones can be incredibly intelligent and make useless decisions, and two can be very dumb and still be twos. There's no real hierarchy. We're all the same. We are a reflection of each other. But if people were more cognizant of their choices, I think they could make different ones if they want. Mm-hmm. There's no reason to, right, though? Like, look at all these different versions of them in their universes. There's no reason for them to change the way they are until joy. But even with joy, I don't know. Like, does it, I don't know if, I don't know. I don't want to control people, but I want to give people an option for, like, you don't have to feel bad about these things. Or you can feel bad about these things. Like you said earlier, Kyla, like, we want to give people options for their life. You want to be a stay-at-home partner? Let's talk about openly negotiating that with our people instead of tricking people into marrying us and then being like, I don't want to work. Which I've seen people do. I've seen people trick people into marrying them and then being like, I'm not going to work. Support me. And I'm like, why do you have to do that? Like, why? Because we're afraid. We're afraid we can't have the future we want. And I think that that's a fair fear. But I also think it's a fear we put on ourselves. Like, we create it. We self-sabotage.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Totally. Totally.
Yeah, it's so good. It's very much like brings this principle that I think is really important of like, we're made by our environment, but we also get to make our environment. Like, there's some level of choice in there, which is that like, you do get to choose the environment. Yeah, which is nice, it's like nothing matters at all. It's like, oh man, the scene... I won't go into details because there's a bunch of people who are like, stop fucking spoiling thing. But when they're talking about this idea of like, everything's stupid, nothing matters because like, we're just a blip. We're just a vapor on this planet. And so nothing matters. And I'm like, exactly. Nothing matters. And that's why when you make things matter, when you choose to imbue it with meaning, that's why it matters so much because it makes it different from everything else because nothing else matters except for the things that you choose to make meaningful. That's why life matters.
Yes.
And I'm just, just really.
No, that's
100%. It's like my favorite scene. Mm-hmm. I won't allude to what the scene is, but that scene where they talk about that is my favorite scene.
No, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, I think that's what it is. Is like that. I think you have to go through cycles. So you have to go through this thing where you go, nothing matters, finish that out. Then you have to go back to the beginning and go, so if nothing matters, what now? Now you find things that matter. And then when that happens, you're afraid of losing things. You feel the real fear, the honor of loving something enough to fear it being lost. Right? And that is such a huge, like, I don't want to say burden, but it is kind of a burden. It's like the way I feel about, like, this. Like, someone was like, Brittany, don't you think it's gross you live with your siblings? I was like, don't you think it's gross that you don't have a bond with your siblings to the point where you don't talk to them?
Yeah.
Like, are you seriously telling me on this fucking stupid planet Earth that I was forced to be in and didn't consent to being alive that I don't get to choose to live with the coolest people on Earth when I wake up every fucking day? We share a coffee. We hang out. We laugh. We cry together. Oh, I'm sorry. Am I supposed to not want that? Fuck off. No, people are just like, they don't believe it. They don't believe they can be happy because they don't see it around them. And I used to be one of those people who woke up every day wanting to kill myself, tried a few times, but ultimately it took my own fucking work to have the life I wanted. It started with me. 100% did.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And then it took everyone else around me doing it too. Like, people still have to do it though. Like, we have to do things. It's kind of crazy though. Like, especially if you live in a really privileged world like America. If you live in America, period, you're privileged. So just like, use that privilege of living in America. and use it to your advantage because it's here. Like, it is here in this country. I don't know about Canada or Sweden, but it's definitely here in America because there's loopholes, baby. Lots of loopholes.
Yeah.
You know? But it's going to take a lot of reading. Sorry. I also cheated. I've read over, like, 2,000 books. So I, like, have all that information in my head. So you do have to read, which is hard.
Mm-hmm. If someone in chat has not seen it, you guys should go watch it. And also, watch it in theater. Because I thought about this now that we talked about it, too. It was an experience sitting there with all these people that you don't know. And everyone is emotional and, like, crying. Because you know that they're thinking about their own life, too, when they're watching the movie. So you get this experience of, like, everyone really has their own life with all their stuff going on.
Yes.
And, like, everyone has, like, a really weak spot somewhere. And it's so nice to just feel everyone being so vulnerable in this moment together with a bunch of people you don't know. Yes. Is the coolest experience. I love that.
And so they're all us. So nice. Like, they're all us. Like, I was at Walmart with my brother and we were looking at people and I'm like, they're us, bro. Like, they're in their own version of our life. And he was like, I know, bro. He's like, isn't that weird? They're playing out this script. Because, like, how are their life any different from my life, really? Like, we all moms and dads and families and people, and we're all, like, at Walmart. We're all choosing to shop at Walmart. It's, like, we're all the same in the end, and it's crazy. And it's beautiful. It's fucking awesome. Like, it really is cool to be a person. Holy shit. Yeah. It's really great.
It's – I always – whenever I go to, like rodeos or, like, events that have lots of animals at them, I'm always like, people are very strange. Like, I wonder what this cow thinks of everything. Like, it's just fucking chilling – and, like, being a cow, and it's, like, looking out of this enclosure that men made for it, standing in this, like, random dome because men have decided to fucking ride it with a bucking strap. It's just, like, watching a whole bunch of humies walking by, and it's just, like, you know, just being a fucking cow. And then humans are just strange, you know? We just, like, create.
Totally.
We're just so strange. I don't know. Humans are just, I would just wonder what animals think of humans. Like,
I'm curious.
Guys, chill. Or, like.
Constantly. Like, especially dogs that are really smarter, Indiana, like my cat, she'll do things and I'm like, you see that? She's looking at us right now and thinking, this dumb human, if I do this, she'll give me this. And I'm like, she's right. She does know me. She's right. I will do that. So, like, yeah, there's something really beautiful about it, actually. Somebody asked me, can the levels be, can animals experience the levels? And I was like, and I looked at them and I was like, man, are you asking me if animals have a consciousness? And they're like, yeah. I was like, yes, they do. So I guess they're twos. God damn it. I hate this conversation. But, like, I think animals, some animals do have a consciousness like humans. And then I meet humans that are kind of like animals. And I'm like, they're kind of dead in the eyes. So I think we are animals. Like, I don't know why we're here on planet Earth. But I'm pretty sure we're just animals, like, evolved over time. And our consciousness just allowed us to be a little bit more interesting. But animals are kind of, like, equally interesting to me personally. In here, you guys need to come visit. There's, like, wild elk and deer everywhere, and we can go on these hiking trails, and you'll just run into herds of animals, and the elk will look at you, and they'll be like this. They'll be like, you're near my woman. And I'm like, damn, just like a man. Just like a man. Like, it's very, it's crazy. It's beautiful, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I believe
It's dope. Yeah.
I like the idea of dolphins, because they're very smart too, and they're kind of like, when you see a dolphin, you just know that they are aware of so many things. And it's so strange also because they're also, like, sexually active for pleasure.
Totally.
And they also can get sexually attracted to humans.
I mean,
which is also very interesting.
True.
Right.
There's a documentary about a guy who fell in love with a dolphin. Really weird. It's a really weird documentary.
Far out for me, but, like, interesting. There's parrots that have the same intelligence level as, like, 3-year-old children, which brought out, like, this ethical discussion of whether or not we should cage parrots. And I was like, that's really interesting, like, to have those questions of, like, if animals have enough, what if we build a technology one day to give my cat vocals? Does that mean we cats eventually should be able to vote and, like, be a part of society? Like, it's very, it's a fun conversation to have, but it's very, like, I love what-ifing. I could what-if all day. What if this happens? Like, I could do it all day.
Yeah, that's fair. I mean, I don't know if I want to know, right? Like, you know, my dog sees a lot of shit, you know? I don't know if I want to hear her thoughts on it.
For sure.
Yeah. You know, I kind of enjoy the unconditional love and silent acceptance. But maybe it's not silent. Maybe she's gay judging me constantly. She's like, are you sure you're going to wear that outfit? Mm-hmm. I'm not sure. Are you sure about that? Yeah, but okay, whatever.
I'm telling you.
Have you guys ever seen a TV show, Wilfred?
Wilfred?
Yeah, Wilfred. It's about that Australian dog that everyone sees a dog, but Elijah Wood, who plays
Frodo. Oh, I thought it was Elijah. I haven't seen it, but I know which one
yes.
it is.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Everyone sees a dog, but he sees a human, and the exactly. dog looks super mean,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, and he's like fucking with them all the time.
Yeah.
And, like, he's mind games with them, yeah. I've seen that show so many times, like over and over and over again. It might be one of my favorites, I think.
I need to watch
because
it.
Because I was like 12 when I started watching it, and then like from time to time I go back watching it again.
Is it a TV really series?
Funny. Yeah. Yeah. It's really...
It's very...
I remember seeing it and thinking, oh, I wonder... What is it on, though? HBO or something like that?
I'm not sure. I don't remember.
Okay, Wilfred.
I don't remember,
Elijah
yeah.
Elijah Wood.
Yeah.
Elijah Wood.
It's funny.
That
it's
sounds... Funny. I remember
seeing
it.
It's like a comedy. It's like a dark comedy. It's very existential as well. Like, it's... Everything is just crazy. And I remember I was probably way too young to watch this TV show. But I really like it. It's funny.
Yeah, there's a lot of like inappropriate jokes.
Yes, but also like a lot of existential stuff. He's basically like the whole point of the TV show is like it's like funny. There's a lot of funny stuff happening. It's like comedy. But then there's a lot of like, why is he seeing this dog like this? Is he crazy? Is he schizophrenic? Like, is he living in some universe where everyone...
Oh, it like breaks the medium. Crazy?
Yeah, it breaks. Like, it breaks down a lot of like theories about life. So everything was just really, really crazy. And that the whole TV show is like him trying to find out or figure out why he sees this dog as a human. Yeah.
That's so interesting, actually. Existential is what
somebody... A lot of existential. I love that show. I remember watching this, yeah. I remember I was watching this alone, like at my country house on my computer, really shit internet, just like lagged through the whole thing. And I was just like obsessed watching this show. And I remember I didn't want to tell my parents because I was probably a little too young to like watch this because it's a lot of crazy stuff. But I remember that sometimes I would go to bed feeling like shit because it was like too much information about the universe and like about existing basically, like theories. And I would be like, wait, this is way too much for my 12-year-old brain.
Yeah, that's yeah. fair. That's kind of how I feel whenever I get into like existential, like psychotherapy theories and stuff like that. It's just like, it's kind of mind fucking where you're like,
hold on.
I shouldn't know this. I'm not meant to know this.
You
know?
Can you guys hear something on my mic? Yes. What is it?
It sounds like a air conditioner or like a fan. Mm-hmm. It's like a white noise. I'm not sure what it is. Now it's gone. Kind of. It's back.
I don't know.
Is it just my computer fan?
It might be. Might be. It sounds like something is printing out something.
That's so fucking weird. Yeah, I think it's just my computer, but why did it just start? It's probably overheating.
Mm-hmm. Getting too hot.
Yeah, it's probably overheating. That's so funny. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that.
I think I'm going to have to go pretty soon because we have like a dinner thing that we're going to leave for in 8 minutes.
Perfect.
But
actually.
I want to talk the movie more.
I know. Yeah, it's so too. Good. It's so good.
I also have to get going because I have a public talk to give tonight. But if you guys want to chat about the movie sometime, I'm super... Maybe we can give it like 2 weeks so people in our chats, you guys have two weeks.
I want to see it again too. I think it comes out
2 weeks. And then you're fucked. Then we're going to spoil all of it, all right?
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure it does come out this week. So like I'll check Prime people because like I'm going to get it right away. Mm-hmm. And watch it again.
And watch it. And if you don't care, then...
Exactly. All right. This was so great, girls. Thank you so much for coming.
I love hanging out with you guys. It's really nice.
Wait,
it's
did we decide? Are we friends?
Yes.
I'd like to be friends. I would like to be friends. Yes.
Based. When is that event, Brittany? I always forget what it's called. The kink.
It starts in September, usually around September, and I can look it up too to see if it would work this year. But it's in San Francisco, so. It's a, you know, and then we could get like an Airbnb or a hotel to save on costs or whatever, and that would be easy. I'll look it up, though. I'll send you guys links.
Okay.
That sounds great.
Perfect.
I'm super down.
Okay. Perfect. Okay, cool. All right, girls. Enjoy your evenings, and we'll chat soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.